just about this person, right? We already know James. We know what he does. Yes. And we have here. And then we have another person in here who is
Barulizales.
Yeah. And you know, I'm going to say mamacita, no, just as the way. Okay. So we have Amparito here. Last classes, we were having a discussion, having a series of ideas around the physical description of this person. That's what probably Vanessa said, he was a handsome guy, right? Yeah? What is the question? What is the question you use to describe Hans? What does he look like? What does he look like? That is the question for physical description concerning Hans. And then we have this question for Amparo. What was the question? The same way? What does he look like? Okay. Normally we make descriptions considering two potential aspects. We use to be for general descriptions and to have for physical description of the parts of the body, of course. For example, what can we say in general terms about hands? Vane, what are you projecting?
Osh.
Osh. Osh. Okay. General terms. Okay, good. He is tall. He's taller than you, and he's taller than you. He's kind of tall. He has black hair.
Slim.
What else? He's brunette. He's young. What else? Okay, with the parts of the body of James. Mention the whole sentence.
He has brown eyes.
He has brown eyes. What else? We're going to see
what
Amparo is. She's only old. Remember?
No,
remember
that?
Remember
really
the three?
Really old.
Okay. You remember the three last words we learned? ¿Se acuerdan de las tres últimas palabritas que aprendimos en la clase? Que hemos tres grados diferentes. Very. White. And ready. So that it says
she is really old.
She is really old.
Really?
Yeah.
She's really?
She is plain, yeah, definitely. Probably like a mommy. Yeah? But she's plain. Good. What else?
She's brunette.
She's brunette. Check it out. You have a new mail on your yes, that information is for you. Info. There, we will find many words concerning vocabulary that has to do with personality. Todas esas palabritas que están acá nos sirven para describir la personalidad. Cada vez que nosotros estemos hablando de la personalidad, vamos a utilizar, más que nada, to be, verb to be. The idea now is that we check first the pronunciation of those words, and then we check the meaning. Check the meaning by examples. Let's see. You help me to repeat after me. You have the words? We have ambitious, annoying, argumentative, quarrelsome, bad temper. What are the familiar words to us, please? Las que ustedes ya conocen. For example, ambitious. Ambitious, yes? Ambitious, okay, conventional, sensible and sensitive are really different. Yeah? Sensible and sensitive have very different meanings. Any other word that you already know? Que ya una otra palabra que ya conozcan. You're going to look on the dictionary the meaning of the other words you have on that list. And after that, I am sending you a link to describe some people. And we will finish working on the description for Amparo and Hamis as well. Okay. Let's continue checking the meanings of the words we have searched so far. Ambitious, we know what is ambitious. What is annoying? Yeah, argumentative person. A person who likes to discuss, but in a good mood, with proposals, with ideas. Mean. Or? Yeah. Or? Also. A person who is not generous. James. Let's go back to James. Modest. Okay. He is modest. What else?
Friendly.
Sure. What else?
Brave.
Definitely. Brave.
Generous,
yes.
Sí, con su fundación.
Uh-huh, exactly, that's it.
Sí.
Yes, we have a foundation. We have something to do. I want you to go again to your Aula de accounts and open the link you have in this moment. You have a link. On this link, you find information about certain people. Good. What did you find? Please tell me. Information about
the Simpsons
characters. The Simpsons characters. We have different and many Simpsons characters. You know the show, right? Yes. For many years we have watched the Simpsons. And these people are really, really, really particular. Yes? Some of these characters are funny, some of these characters are boring. What I want you to do is, I want you to help me to answer this question about two different characters. What is he like and what is she like? I want you to choose two different characters in your opinion. Two characters that are different in personality, and make a description of every person. You will use five sentences to describe one person, or person A, and 5 sentences to describe person B. But you won't tell anybody, ustedes no van a decir a quién están describiendo. Sencillamente van a colocar las características y eventualmente nosotros intentaremos averiguar de quién se trata. We will try to guess. Vamos a tratar de adivinar cómo nos. We start with you. Only one of the two characters. Only one.
He is
cruel. What else? Ambitious. Continue.
Is
dull.
He.
Annoying. And
he.
He is bad tempered. Remember, pronunciation is he. You can pass it to level 2 saying hey. He. Okay, thanks. So we know that those are characteristics for Mr. Burns. Listen, I'm going to mention my character and you will tell me who this character is. This person is funny. This person is crazy. This person, hold on, it's not crossing. This person is ambitious. This person is not trustworthy. Not trustworthy. And this person is and mean. And it is not Burns. Nope. He's funny, but he's mean.
Crosby.
He's not Crosby. Which one? Nope. Nope. Look at the names. Look at the names of the.
Really?
Not really. Cantacross, funny, ambitious, evil, evil, evil. But what is the name in English? What is the name for
Sideshow
Bob? Sideshow Bob. That is the character. Go, Molly. Now, you see, it's not that difficult to understand how to describe people.